York's top asset skipped his exit interview at the close of the season.
When a guy doesn't show up at an exit meeting, everybody starts speculating on, you know, the duration or his, you know, mobility from a club. So we've been getting calls, and you know, we're listening, but we're not intrigued yet at this level. But as much as we love this guy, you know, we have to do what's good for our club.
And what would be good for the club? Why would you do that?
Future. You know, what it brings to bring us two starters and a draft pick, or, you know, something that's even beyond that is something that we have to look at as far as going down the road. We know what he is. He's a unicorn and he's special.
Was missing that exit interview a big deal or not?
I don't think I've ever had a player over 25 years of coaching, maybe 30, not coming to an exit meeting. So it's not happened. I know it happens to other people and other players. And his, you know, his brother and his agent have said, you know, downplayed it, but, you know, still it's a chance for a person to express themselves. And I had a real good relationship with Chris Dobbs over the last 2 years, so it was kind of surprising.
Does there need to be some repairing?
We've reached out. You know, we've communicated, not through voice or anything.